good all the time.
All the time God is good.
Yes, he is. David said it best when he said, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord.
Yep.
He also said, this is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. Do we have any prayer requests? Physically, but we know a God that's able to heal.
Yeah.
He's still in the healing business. We just got to keep the faith.
Right.
If you look back over all the scriptures, every time Jesus healed somebody, he told them, your faith is what's made you whole.
Exactly.
Amen.
give the call because ever since they went down my throat and went in there and shot my heart back in the rhythm, I ain't had a good voice.
Thank you.
Yeah. You say, Oh,
Come on and hold to
walk it out to the air, where it's lost on the breeze. Some just see tear drops fall into the floor, just a waste of time. Not any goal, but it's a direct line to the throne room, where you can find someone who cares. And if you need someone wrong, I can tell you that
saying, this is a new day. This is a new beginning for everyone that was here today. And if you're out there and you're listening and you've been joining in, it can be a new day for you too if you'll just take that first step. Like I told Brother Darrell, I felt led to tell him that he gives healing only when he begins to believe God by taking that first step, and God has really brought him from a long, long way. And he's going to take you further, Brother Darrell, if you'll just be obedient to him and keep your mind upon him and not pay attention to what people are saying or doing around you.
Amen.
But keep your mind upon God, and he will direct your path and what needs to be done. And those people that are packing tails or whatever, I don't know why I said that, but maybe they are. I don't know what's going on in your life, Brother Darrell. But people that are packing tails, they're going to be brought low.
Yes.
And when they get low, you're going to be able to help them. You're going to be able to pull them about the pit of hell. And I believe and trust that you have a work for God.
Yes.
You have a work, Brother Darrell. But you have to be the one to take the first step and believe that God will direct your path in every situation that he calls you to do.
Amen.
And I praise God that God does speak to us in our hearts and in our minds, and he helps us through every situation, just like the situations that I've been through here in my last few months. God, they've been hard, but God has surely been with me. And I keep feeling that right in the back of my mind. I felt that even before Lehman passed away, right there as I was praying in his bathroom just a day or two before. He said, "You'll be a light." And then when that happened, I thought, "God, how can I be a light? You took him away from me, and I'm not around his family anymore. But I know that they see me, and they know that I serve God. And I know that I can help somebody. And especially Deborah, I've been talking to her and trying to get her back in the church. And if you're listening today, Deborah, I love you just like a daughter. And I pray for you every day just like a daughter. And for Bob and for Tom and for Justin, all of you all, I pray for you all. I don't know all of his family, but God knows all about every one of them. And God knows what he was doing when he put me and Lehman together, because if he hadn't put me with Lehman, I wouldn't have been able to know all these people and to try to help them. But I know God has everything planned out just the way he wants it to be planned out. It might not be what we want or what we think we should have, but it'll be just what God wants us to have. And that'll be the best thing for us, is to have exactly what God wants us to have. And I praise God for his amazing grace. And if you're so glad for the amazing grace, let's hear you sing together, "Amazing Grace."
we've had church.
Praise the Lord.
I love when God shows up.
Amen. Amen.
There's no preaching that I can do to even touch what God's anointing is.
Also, too, if you guys don't, Sabrina next to your tonight, her little granddaughter got bit by her son's dog.
Oh, my Jesus.
And you know, he said, so she couldn't have fallen off when she had bad headaches, and she had stitches, and she was going to come to that. So just pray for her.
No.
Yeah, she wants to see her.
Jesus. I don't want to go somewhere else, but I was reading these scriptures. We can't get out without reading God's word.
Brother.
And I'm not even going to try to top what God's done. If you have your Bibles, turn to the 41st chapter of Isaiah. Isaiah chapter 41. Over the last couple of weeks, Sister Betty, it's repeatedly kept coming over and over in my mind. We needed to have a healing service.
Yes, amen.
And I thought, kept thinking to myself, Dad, well, I've been into many of those. So I flash like flash years, I start trying to think, well, how can I set one up?
Yep.
So I started thinking about the scripture that the man that was laid 38 years by the Bethesda school, and how the angel come down once a year and stirred the water, and whoever stepped in first was made whole.
Yep.
And I started picturing one of them little kiddie swimming pools with a little bit of water in it, and everybody waiting through the water, and that'd be a healing service. And I've actually done that before when I was preaching to a youth group. And our God came down. But never did I imagine a spontaneous. I thought it was something, Sister Betty, I was going to have to put a whole lot of work in. Other than being obedient today, I didn't have to do nothing. But I've been to several different places in Scripture, and I just think this is fitting right here. It's Isaiah 41. Let's start reading at verse 10. It says, "Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee. Yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Behold, all they that were incensed against thee," as many of you mentioned shutting the mouth, love, because listen to what it says, "incensed against thee shall be ashamed and confounded."
Yep.
"They shall be as nothing."
Right. Yep.
"And they that strive with thee shall perish." That strive there don't mean they're working with you. It means they're coming against you. It says, "They shall perish. Thou shalt seek them," meaning you might look for them, "and shall not find them." Just like the children who, when they crossed the Red Sea, once they crossed over, God told them not to see them no more. It says, Even them that contended with thee, they that war against thee shall be as nothing and as a thing of naught. For I, the Lord thy God, will hold thy right hand, saying unto thee, Fear not. I will help thee. Fear not. Thou worm Jacob, and ye men of Israel, I will help thee, saith the Lord, and they and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. Amen. I have had four or five different places marked for today, and that's not even the scripture I thought I was going to go into, but that's all right. Because like I said, God did the preaching 100% today through His Holy Spirit and through a sporadic healing service. The body of Christ, not just you and I that sit here today, the body of Christ has been going through a war. And I'm afraid that they're not listening to God. And that's why they're suffering more than they need to suffer. And I don't stand here and say that lightly, because we're all human. We've all done that and decided, Sister Betty, well, I'm going to do things my way. But then God lays us up in some way, shape, form, or fashion to get our attention.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Anybody want to testify real quick of the goodness of God?
What a healing.
can't find it. But I thought about that song. That little support came to me all last week.
Yes.
And I never thought about it.
That says a lot.
It sure does. Anyone else want this?
Situation, we pray, God.
The Lord, lift Sabrina, show Sabrina, you have her to do the following.